Okay, so for today's video, right, we are actually going to show you guys our brand new Red Sea Reefer Nano. Okay, so for a couple of months back, I believe it's a couple of months ago, we actually got ourselves this Red Sea Reefer Nano. So the only reason why I get this tank, right, is because previously this spot here, right, is actually the Innovative Marine 25. If you guys have not seen that whole series of video, right, I leave a link up right now. So previously this whole spot, right, was more like a little small nano tank concept where I just want to do something very simple, and then it's like a little tank that doesn't require a lot of maintenance before the actual the COVID tank that came up after that. So after moving out the Nano 25, right, I did mention before that I probably might want to keep the 25. I might not keep the 25 for a couple of reasons, and I decided not to keep the 25 gallon, and then I went with this instead. A few reasons why. First up is because Red Sea they're actually going to come out with a new line of newer models of the Red Sea tanks, which I believe they came out with the XL200, the XL300 this year. So they're actually pretty phasing out the older Nano models, as well as the other models like the 170, 250, 300, that kind. And the reason why are they doing so, right, is there's a couple of upgrades that they are doing from the newer Y nozzle outlet to the SAM itself, right. There's actually a lot of newer upgrades and newer installations on the newer tanks. So when they decided to phase this Nano out, right, the couple of things that really enticed me about is the price point, because they actually went down for a very good discounted rate back then. So I actually got our main sponsors, Reef Market SG, to hook me up with one of these guys, which is the white version, which I always wanted to try a Red Sea tank, but then I did not really have the space, the finances to actually afford a large Red Sea tank. So I decided to, why not give a try with the smaller Nano, since the time was good. I had a new space, I'm upgrading a new tank, and they had a good discount on them. So this is why they sent me this tank after that, just to give you guys a trial out and a review. For those of you guys who want to try a Red Sea Nano tank, which is like an all-in-one build system, right? I'm going to share with you guys what I like about a Red Sea tank and what I don't really like about a Red Sea tank. So first up, right, let me mention to you guys a little bit about why I actually did the upgrade. So the 25 gallon is good. The size of the tank is really nice. But then one thing about all the IOS, which is the internal overflow tanks, which is they are very small sump area. They don't even have a sump. It's more like a back internal overflow area, which somehow limits you to the amount of things that you can do in that tank. So water volume wise is pretty standard, and then the equipment wise are really tiny. And I don't really like about this, because like if you want a chiller, an external pump, and then like your protein scheme and stuff like that, right, you're very restricted with space at the back. So when this guy came out, right, even though it looks pretty big, but to me it's still a nano tank, because footprint wise it's a very very small tank. It's only about 1 feet plus 45 by 45, so it's still a small tank. But the good thing about it, right, it actually has a sump, which I will show it to you later. And then the next reason why I wanted to upgrade, right, is also because I wanted to try a Red Sea tank for just to give myself a feel on how a fully made, this is what we usually call a standard out of the factory tank, where the tank, the cabinet, the sump, and everything in it, right, is built by one brand. So everything it works nicely, compared if you get a custom build, right, your cabinet, your sump, your equipment, everything is very different. And then you may come into a little hiccups here and there, like for the COVID tank, equipment wise, some of the things I need to fine tune, I need to change, I need to even modify some parts to get that done. Well, compared to this, right, it's an all-in-one system built by one company. So everything looks very slick, it looks very nice, it's clean. If you guys want a clean look, right, the Red Sea line actually gives you guys this very nice clean look. And the good thing about it, right, is it's crystal glass, and the build manufacturer is pretty nice. Overall, it's very clean, everything is done very nicely. You don't really get like very awkward silicone on the side, stains, scratches. Even the cabinet itself looks good from the marine spec in front, But however, when they say a marine spec laminated cabinet, right, it's only the front door, not onto the side. The side is still, it feels like normal lamination compared to the front, this glossy vibe. Same like most reviews, right? Some people would recommend that Red Sea can do it on all three sides. Will be better. I have the same review as well. I would like to see it on this end and this end, and not just the front, this really nice epoxy finish material. So this is the tank. I've not decided what to do with the tank yet, but then let me show you guys a couple of very interesting features. So come closer, then I'll show you guys. So from the start of this whole build, right, let's begin with the lighting. So for the light itself, right, we actually got same thing from Reef Market SG. They actually hooked us up with their newer range of the smaller lights that they have. So if you guys seen the previous one on the COVID tank, right, we're actually running the R80. This is like the smaller model, but it's the newer upgraded model, which they call it the LG40, that is currently running this tank. So same thing, it actually has the full app control. The app is the same app as the R80, but then recently they actually did a software update on the app, which looks really a lot more nicer and looking more professional compared to the previous app that I showed you guys, which you guys see in the screen right now, right? It's actually a lot cleaner, and you can actually do like all the graphs and everything, and the automation section, right, is actually a lot more nicer. The interface is a lot more nicer on the app. So about the, when I previously mentioned about the R80, right, I did say that the app needs a bit of work, but looks like they actually did listen to my advice and they actually did an upgrade on the app itself. So I'm kind of really interested in the app right now and with the built-in Wi-Fi. But however, the thing that I still don't like about this, right, is the Wi-Fi feature. When it comes to this, right, you still have to connect to the Wi-Fi, then the Wi-Fi connect to this. Well, however, I'm actually being pretty spoiled by the AI right now, where it's more Bluetooth. You can just connect straight to the app itself. So if this thing in the future moves on to like the Bluetooth function, right, it will be pretty cool. But the app, the light itself is pretty nice. The footprint is really small. It runs on a very nice gooseneck right behind here. And then it actually covers the footprint of the 45x45 very well. So I believe one light is sufficient enough for the tank. And Red Sea, right, they actually have this little slot here which you can actually break. I believe you're supposed to break this. I broke mine, lah, so I don't know whether it is correct or not, but I actually did broke mine to actually fit in the little small bracket over here, which can run the tank, so you can stick in really, really nicely into the tank here. So, like overall mentioned here, right, you have the little nozzle. This thing actually allows you to rotate left and right. This really, really nice the overflow guard here, which you can actually remove this for cleaning. But then it's very clean, it's very slick. Inside, you can actually get the both overflow outlet. You have the main overflow and then the return, which you can control from then on. And then the main tank itself, right, I have not decided what I want to do with it yet. I'm thinking of an anemone cube. So, okay, I was thinking of either going a full anemone cube, so basically just getting rocks up to this high, and then just like do a full RBTA, or maybe like a couple of mixed bubble tips and a couple of like Magnifica carpets in this tank. So a full RBTA tank with like a harem of clownfish. If you guys have never seen a harem tank, right, I'll probably want to do this in the harem tank. This is one of the ideas that I want to. The other idea that I want to do, right, is to make this into a full macro algae tank, which is more like a full macro algae. The different types of macro algae inside there, like dragon's breath, the sea grapes, and then after that, right, do a little bit of cleanse and soft coral into this tank. So that's option two, which is a macro algae tank. The third option, which is to do this into a non-photosynthetic tank. So basically to make this an NPS dominated tank. Basically sun coral, super sun, and then a couple of gorgonians here and there, right? To make this a very deep looking tank, pretty high up, reef wall kind, with a lot of crevices here and there, and then like just do a non-photosynthetic tank with very dim lights, and then probably the fishes inside here, right? I was thinking of going a bit deeper water kind of concept. So that is like one of the things that I would love to see in this tank, which three options. If you guys have, I will leave this to you guys to decide which tank, which one do you guys want to see. You guys want to see the full anemone tank, the macro algae tank, or you guys want to see a non-photosynthetic tank. So leave in the comment section below on which do you want to see, and then we will get this filled up, and at the same time, I will review to you guys what is the most popular choice that you guys actually recommend for this tank. So another thing is that I want to say is that should I remove the back sticker or not? So if you guys have seen a lot of other Red Sea Reefer users, right, they always remove this back. So it actually gives that very nice crystal clear throughout the back, the white wall. It just gives that depth into it. But maintenance is another problem because you need to clean an extra wall at the back to always maintain that crystal clear vibes on the tank. So I have really no idea whether should I remove it or not yet. So I'm actually leaving it on for now and just to see how it actually goes. But this should be the main overall. It's very nicely done. Overall, I like the glass. I love how the look of the tank is. Everything looks good, really looks good. So for small nano tanks like this, right, it's kind of really nice in the setup. So this is one thing that I'll probably keep for a very long time. Even when I move over, right, I'll probably do this in the study room or even in my bedroom on the side tank, because Red Seas are actually a really, really quiet tank. So I'll probably keep this for my house next time as well. Probably keep this in the bedroom. If the wife approves, probably this will be on the bedside. If she approves, which she is behind the camera right now and she's not agreeing to it, but then I believe it's quite a nice bedside tank. So if she agrees to it, you will see this in the future, in our future new home beside the bed. All right? Okay, so next up, right, let's show you the cabinet itself. So it's a push open cabinet, which I don't know how to push it open. Oh, sorry, it's this side. Yeah, so it's a push open cabinet, which I will show you guys inside from now on. Okay, so inside, right, it's pretty simple. They have the main, the flexible tube here, which actually connects to your return pump, which I will show you later what I'm actually going to use for my return pump. These two over here, one is the main valve, the main drainage area, which you can actually control over here to fine tune how much water is coming down into the main drain. You have the emergency one, which both flows into this section over here. So it actually flows in here and then it goes into the little small, I believe this is like a 2-inch or a 4, I don't think it's 4-inch, but a slightly smaller filter sock, which you can actually pull it out for maintenance and stuff like that. And then it flows into the main chamber here. So I don't think I will be running any mechanical filtration over here. I was thinking of just doing like a full, probably a macro algae tank with just a small light coming out. So that is what I should probably do. And then to the return pump and then back straight up to the tank. So I have really no idea what am I supposed to do inside here. Oh, there is a auto top up little container here, which I probably think I will use it. But then a lot of people have been complaining about the Red Sea's float switch, which kind of is pretty annoying, which I do agree, because gravity fed, right, sometimes you cannot turn this off. So if, let's say, if the water drains, right, you might flood the whole tank with fresh water. But we'll see how this goes. But then this is how the overall sum looks like. No skimmer. I'm not going to plan to run. There's no skimmer, no reactor, no chiller on this tank. It's just going to probably run a macro algae and then a little fan in here just to keep everything cool. This is going to be a very, very low maintenance tank, so I don't really want to do much with this tank. So let me show you what pump am I going to use right now. Okay, so this is actually the pump that we'll be using for this tank. So this is also sponsored by Reef Market SG. So this is pretty interesting. It's the first time I actually had a red pump. It's a very different, like, from all the other JBL pumps that I have. Like, this is actually fully red. It's also a DC pump. But then the very interesting thing about this, right, this is actually Wi-Fi connected. So you can actually download the app itself. You can actually control this pump via an app, which I kind of really don't understand why you need Wi-Fi on a pump though. Like, it's just a pump, right? Like, you just set it at one speed and just leave it all the way. So I really have no idea why do they need a Wi-Fi feature on that. Once I get it hooked up and then I download the app, right, I'll probably give you guys another video once this is filled with the tank, the pump running. And maybe there's other features, like for example, like your EcoTech, you can actually set your pump at different speed rates throughout the day. I don't know about this, it's pretty new to me. It's a very new product by them, which our dear sponsor sent it to me, so I'll probably give this a try. I'll play with the app more once this is run with water and everything, and then I'll let you guys know actually what kind of new features can this Wi-Fi pump does. So let's open it up and then I will show you guys what's inside here. So you have the pump, which it's slightly, it's pretty small. Like the pump footprint is only about this size. So the pump, it's a J-bar pump, so you don't really expect a very, very like quality finish build. It feels the typical cheap plastic kind of material, which I don't expect more from the price that you pay lah. So I'm kind of okay with it, but then it looks nice, the red and everything. So small footprint, pretty good for a small size pump like this. So kind of really nice. And then inside the pump, you have your typical bulkheads and then the controller, which is also in red. So I'll probably mount this either in or outside the tank. And then I will get this hooked up to the tank. And then after that, once it's filled with water, right, upcoming video, once this is wet, I will show you guys a bit more on the pump. And then we will see a couple of escapes. And what are we actually going to do with the tank from then on. Okay, so I believe we have come to the end of today's video. So for upcoming next few videos, right, we will be actually sharing with you guys on this tank build as well as the COVID tank, the progress, once it's wet, the scape that it's going in, and then what is the theming for this tank, whether is it a full anemone tank, is it going to be a non-fluorescent tank, or is it going to be a macro algae tank. That is up to you guys to decide what you guys want to see for this tank. So same thing, leave a comment down below on what you guys want to see in this tank build. But before anything, right, if you guys see the shirt that I'm actually wearing right now, right, this is actually a done up by our own self for the brand itself. So I will be coming out with a couple of merchandises, new logos, a couple of posters for the channel. So I will probably add all this stuff into the next giveaway. So if you guys want to buy something, right, I will also be doing a little bit of a merchant store here and there to get a couple of this stuff. So if you guys are interested in like t-shirts like this, posters like this on the wall, right, or like you guys want to see a couple of more merchandises, buy stickers, posters and all these other stuff, t-shirts, right, do leave a comment down below as well. You can always check me on the Instagram page if you guys want something, or I'm always really glad to send anything out to you guys locally as well as to support the overseas fans, right. I believe I can ship t-shirts and stuff out except for livestock. So these are the stuff that I will be doing for you guys, just to give you guys just to appreciate for all the support that you guys been putting up for me. So I'll end this video here. Same thing, if you guys like all the videos that we put out for you guys, like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys soon next week.